This is a very old story from Africa, and it's called The Heart of a Monkey. Long ago in Africa, there was a little village. It was right at the edge of the land, at the top of a cliff, and at the bottom of the cliff there were deep waters and other creatures swam in them. Well, every morning at dawn, a big grey monkey would climb up into this tree that was at the very edge of the cliff. Half of its branches hung over the village, half hung over the water. And the monkey thought that the fruit in this tree was the best fruit in the jungle. Well, one morning at dawn, when he'd come to get his breakfast, he was in the branches that hung over the sea, and looking down, he saw somebody looking up at him, and the somebody said, "My dear fellow, would you be so kind as to throw me down one of those sweet things you're eating? I've had nothing but fish for 50 years. I'm sick of the taste of salt." Well, the monkey was a very kind fellow, so he threw a piece of fruit down to the shark, and then he said, "I've got to go home now, back to my wife and family in the jungle, but I'll be here at dawn tomorrow if you like. I can throw you more fruit then." And away he climbed, out of sight. As soon as he was gone, the shark spat out the fruit. Sharks don't eat fruit. They eat bigger, meatier, monkeyer things when they can get them. And the shark had a plan. Every morning at dawn, the monkey came to the fruit tree, had his breakfast and threw fruit down to the shark, who spat them out when the monkey wasn't looking. And every morning they talked. Monkey talked all about his home in the jungle, his wife and his family. Shark didn't listen. Shark talked all about his beautiful underwater home, how it was made of coral and mother of pearl. Monkey listened. Monkey really listened. And when the time was right, the shark said, "My dear fellow, you've been so kind to me, and I have nothing here to give you in return. Why don't you come and visit my home with me? If you see something you like, you can have it as a gift." "Oh, I'd love to," said Monkey, "but I'm scared of getting wet." "That's all right. I'll keep you dry. You can ride on my back. You can trust me." What do you think? Should the monkey trust the shark? No. But Monkey was a very trusting fellow. A few days later, it was all arranged. Monkey slipped down the lowest branches, dropped onto the shark's back, and off they went. Well, at first, Monkey was a little bit... he'd never been to sea before. But after a while, once he got used to the movement of the waves, the water, it was wonderful. There were different birds up in the sky, brightly coloured fish just under the surface of the water. He was having a marvellous time. When they'd been travelling for about 4 hours, the shark said, "My dear fellow, I should tell you, just before we left, I got a message to say my king, the king of the sharks, is sick. The only thing that will cure him is the heart of a monkey." There was a long pause as Monkey realised he'd been tricked. But although he was too trusting about going with the shark, he wasn't stupid. So after the pause, he said, "What a pity you didn't tell me before we set out. I'd have brought my heart with me."
"What do you mean, brought your heart with you?" said the shark.
"Everyone has their hearts with them, inside their bodies." "Not monkeys. We always leave them behind if we go on a journey. I told you I didn't want to get wet. Well, I especially didn't want my heart to get wet, so I left it on the tree before we set off. But I can't wait to see your wonderful underwater home. Carry on!" Well, if the monkey had been asking to turn back, the shark would have been sure this was all a trick. But here was monkey wanting to proceed with the journey. As far as the shark thought, that meant that monkey was really stupid. He must have realised by now that the shark was planning to eat him and feed his heart to the king of the sharks. So he was probably telling the truth. He'd be too stupid to tell a lie. Well, it was the shark who insisted that they turned back and went all the way back to where the branches from the fruit tree hung over the water. And the monkey scrambled up into the branches and said, "I just need to have some fruit and a bit of a sleep before we set off again, and I'll fetch my heart." He climbed up out of sight. And the shark swam round at the bottom of the cliff, and the shark swam round at the bottom of the cliff, and the shark got bored. "Monkey, where are you? We've got a journey to go on." Monkey woke up and looked down. "Are you mad? Do you honestly think I'm going to go with you a second time? Now I know you want to eat me and give my heart to your king. I'm staying where I belong, in this tree. And my heart is staying where it's always been, inside my body." And there was nothing the shark could do about it.